Hey guys, this video is on how to make a cheek slide. This is for lab 7 in the 101 manual. Just to let you know that this is what we're trying to do today. We're trying to make a slide that's going to be stained with methyl blue that's going to have your cheeks in it. So I'm going to lay this over here with the other one that I've made. Now we have a nice clean fresh slide. You may open up the slide box and note that there are papers that are covering the slides. That's to keep them from scratching against each other and getting any kind of damage. So I have a nice clean slide here. You're gonna notice that I have multiple toothpicks. The reason why is an aseptic technique. Since this is touching your body, you're gonna be rubbing the inside of your mouth for a good bit. You're not stabbing. Of course, you're not poking. You're not putting any damage to yourself. The instructions say to use a whole droplet of water. I don't do it that way. I do it a little bit different. I've noticed it's always given me good results. Like, go ahead, I'm gonna rub my sample right here on this slide. And you're gonna notice a shimmer, a sheen. That right there is what you want. It looks like spit, that's okay, that's perfectly normal. So this one's dirty now, I'm gonna put it over here. Then what you can do is there's two methods. You can either start using the water or the methyl blue. I use the methyl blue first. And instead of getting a whole droplet, because you'll realize that this stuff goes really fast and really far. So it's coming out of the bottle here. I'm gonna go ahead and get a little bit of that. I'm not getting a full droplet because that's just way too much solution. But if you notice, I've got a good bit on here, enough to kind of moisten the slide. And so you're gonna rub it on your sample. Note that this is quite a bit. Okay. And if you feel that you just have not added enough blue, you can go ahead and get more parts of that drop because you didn't use the whole drop. And then for the water, now I flip it to the other end. Make sure you're wearing gloves, of course, proper PPE, because you will get dye all over your fingers. And if you know, I have it all over mine. So you're not going to use a whole water droplet either. You're going to go ahead and scrape a little bit off here. Kind of want to moisten your stick. And sometimes you can get a partial droplet on there. Because I have a lot of methyl blue, I don't want that much water. So you're gonna notice it's making this nice, beautiful color. That's good. I'm gonna go ahead and drop it on here. I might give myself a little more. And guess what? You have a lot of slides in your little container. So you can go ahead, actually put it in a lot. And you're gonna, you can make as many as you want. That's just your cheeks that you're gonna be rubbing it on. So this is really, really wet. And we're gonna go ahead and put the cover on there. Now the covers, they have a little plastic, some may have a plastic divider, most of them are paper. You're gonna go ahead and remove that paper. You just want this clear plastic portion. And so we're gonna toss that. Okay, so most people just splat it on. We don't wanna do that. We actually wanna lay it on. So we're gonna go ahead. And once you start, you have to continue, right? You've got to commit. And the reason why is so it kind of splat on there a little bit at the end. It gets air bubbles in it. And so if you notice, if I come forward, those are air bubbles, those clear pockets. We're going to want to focus more on this side where the blue stain is going to be. So I'm going to pop it under the microscope and see how it turned out.